Our subscriber asked us to install Motogadget M-Unit Blue and replace all optics and gauge on his custom bike based on BMW K100RS 9085. The main reason is low quality of components and incomplete functionality. The headlight gets very hot and does not shine well. The gauge does not display a standard set of indicators. Turn signals and brake light are barely visible on the road. They are connected through such a relay, which we immediately cut off. Also, we immediately threw out the aftermarket connectors. Handlebar switch controls can be disconnected. We cut off the headlight. It makes no sense to disassemble it. Anyway, the wiring will be new. Remove all unused connectors. Cut off the relays. Then assembling, we only need this temperature relay with purple wire, which controls the radiator fan. The rest are not needed. The fuse box is also not needed. As a result, we cut off almost everything except the wires of the ignition unit, Motronic and oil pressure sensor. Clean all the working surfaces and elements. The boxes and casing will remain in place, but it is more convenient to remove them for cleaning. I recommend thoroughly cleaning all the elements and wires. Adjustable ABM multi clip-ons I install now to be able to hold the bike and to rotate the front end. Here is M-Unit Blue with Bluetooth connection to smartphone for keyless go function, which replaces fuses and relays. Also, this version works as an alarm and has advanced functionality. We return cleaned casing and boxes to their places. The placement and orientation of M-Unit determines the wiring, the complexity, the assembly and the disassembly of the electric net. I choose horizontal mounting on a plate in the center. It seemed to me the simplest and the most usable. In this case, it is not necessary to drill the box, and the plate can be used as ground. I fixed the only main fuse on such an aluminum bracket. M-Unit is connected and working. OEM starter relay remains. I modified the plate and fixed the temperature relay on it, which controls the radiator fan. I connect the fan via connector and temporarily plug in the relay into auxiliary output. Breakout box is mounted to the left of the M-Unit in the only free corner. This box combines all signals except for the speed sensor and tachometer for transmission over one wire to the MotoscopePro. The instructions indicate the colors of the wires to the lighting devices. It is better to lay them with the margin of length and shorten as the components are installed. In this braid there are power wires for the headlight and turn signals. I pull the braid along the entire length in order to accurately determine the length of the wires. M-Blaze disc turn signals have diameter 14 mm, but ABM clip-ons are equipped with thick-walled tubes with an inner diameter of 12 mm, so they need to be drilled. M-button relay is equipped with long thin wires, which are perfect for push buttons. There are no such wires in the Motogadget kit, although they are the most necessary and rare. Connect the push buttons according to the colors indicated on the M-button relay. This relay combines all the wires into one, which will go to the M-unit. This will greatly reduce the thickness of the braid from the headlight. All the grounds from push buttons are combined inside the control switch body. For this, the kit includes terminals and fasteners. Turn signal, horn and high beam are on the left switch. For the standard functionality of motorcycle, 5 buttons are enough, but there is also a 3 button switch on the right, because the front button will control the gauge menu. Also, there are buttons for the right turn signal and starter, which stops the engine. We install the headlight LSL Eighties in an aluminium body on the old brackets, which I slightly bent for a better fit on the forks. There is enough space in the body to place all connectors and M-button relay. Compact built well throttle instead of OEM one, which had to be removed due to the fact that it is integrated into the switch control. We install aluminium Motogadget grips with unusual mount on the tube. First, I fit it on the tube to make sure that there is no skew and there is a sufficient gap between the grip and the throttle body. The stops are tightened so that the center of the ring coincides with the center of the tube. The grip is not skewed, the clearance is sufficient. Now we can screw in the stops on the thread lock and finally install the grip. It is necessary to wind a rubber around the throttle tube as a spacer. Now we need to feed the turn signal to set the gap and fix the throttle on the clip-on tube. The gap is set in the extreme position, so that the grip does not rub against the turn signal. I install the throttle and the turn signal now to accurately determine the position of the switch and the hole in the tube for the wires. Then marking, we need to take into account the twist of the switch, because the tube cannot be rotating as you like, because of the bend at the fixation point, which gives additional adjustment of the clip-ons. Before drilling, remove the turn signal not to touch its wires. Barbs and sharp edges must be ground off, as they can cut the wire. For the convenience of drilling and wiring, I rotated the tube, so it must be returned to its standard position. Now we can finally install the turn signal. The rubber spacer is tightened by hand, the body must be with the logger upwards, so that the turn signal shines back and forth. MotoscopePro gauge is connected via 9-pin connector. It should include signals from the speed sensor and tachometer, which can be standard from the ignition coils. We hide the wires from the switches in a flexible sleeve. We assemble the connector so that the switch is disconnectable and put it into the headlight. We also make three connectors for the M-button relay, two for the left and right switches and one for power supply with the control wire to M-unit. This wire transmits a digital signal from all buttons. The second switch is installed in the same way. I placed it symmetrically to the right, at a distance from the grip. The grip is installed in the same way as the right one, but with the rubber ring from the kit for a 22mm tube. I decided to lay the wires behind the clip-on risers, as they are less noticeable. To combine all grounds in the headlight, we use a terminal. We put the wire braid in the sleeve. In the future, it will be necessary to connect the brake sensor to the M-button relay in the headlight. It is desirable to fix the ends of the sleeve with the heat shrinkage. On the left side, we also use a sleeve for the braid and an electric tape for a pair of wires. We place the horn on the right, there is already a hole in the frame for it. The plus is laid in the braid, and the minus is connected to a standard place on the frame. At this stage, we can temporarily connect all installed components and start a relay. For the ground, instead of a terminal, we use a thread pin on the plate. The brake box can be powered and connected to the MotoscopePro gauge via the orange wire. We attach the speed sensor via connector, which should be fixed on the frame. In case of brake, the wire comes off the connector, not from the main braid. Turn signals Kelerman Bullet 1000DF are equipped with parking light and a brake light, so there is no need to indent a tail light with the mount. We install them in the old mounts through the washers. The turn signals are certified, very bright, have protection against power surges and can take ground from the body, not to pull extra wire in the braid. But we will make the wire for ground, as the frame may be remade and repainted in the future. The wires are laid compactly behind the starter relay and are connected to the M unit and ground. Next, we install the front master cylinder and bungee bolt with an integrated brake sensor, which is connected to ground through the terminal and to M button relay through the connector. Now the headlight can be finally assembled and fixed. The wire from the OEM fuel level sensor goes to the breakout box. The MotoscopePro should be adjusted in two positions of the fuel level sensor in the corresponding menu. Here is such a ground wires that will go to the neutral sensor, turn signals and breakout box. We have already made a converter of a gear switch sensor to a neutral sensor for a project based on K1100LT. This bike has the same gear switch sensor, so the converter output can be connected to the breakout box. We take the overheating signal from the temperature relay and connect it to the breakout box together with the oil pressure sensor. We don't see a problem if two signals go to the one indicator at MotoscopePro because they have a different switching mode. The rest of the ports are connected to the turn signals and the headlight. In order to have statistics of the speed sensor data in the M-Ride application, it is connected to the second auxiliary input and duplicated on the MotoscopePro for the speedometer and odometer. We connected the control wire from the ignition unit to the first auxiliary input, which is set to the switch mode through the application, so that the output port is turned on only when the engine is running. The fuel pump is powered in this port. The ignition unit is powered to the ignition output. In case the smartphone battery is dead, we decided to keep the standard lock with the key, so you can start the motorcycle in any case. But within a radius of 2 meters, the smartphone provides keyless access. After switching off, the motorcycle starts the security mode, which is confirmed by blinking of the turn signals. The alarm is activated at any movement of the motorcycle, if the smartphone is not nearby. The LED turn signals are very bright. The front ones shine both forward and backward, which increases visibility on a road. Low and high beam are controlled by one button. Horn is on the left front button. On the right front button, navigation in the gauge menu. Neutral switch converter is working correctly and the green indicator lights up only in neutral gear. The standard tachometer signal works correctly without adjustment. You can purchase components and get advice at our Stuntex store. Subscribe if information was interesting.